Good afternoon, guys. Welcome to the seventh webinar, Trading with Hekin Ashi. Great. Let's get started with definition of. So this webinar will cover the three following topics: understanding Hekin Ashi charts. I have been reading your chat messages, and obviously we'll cover both intraday strategies, explaining how BO works, and if time permits, we'll also explore how to use CCI with Hekin Ashi charts. I'll not waste much time on explaining how Hekin Ashi charts are formed, but a little bit of its properties I'll love to discuss so that people understand why it is there and what it means, right? Okay, so let's begin. Okay, so understanding Hekin Ashi formula. Hekin Ashi is made of two Japanese words, which basically where Heiken means average and Ashi means space. Hekin Ashi all is spelled with H-E-I-K-E-N or H-E-I-K-I-N. So both ways, it's fine. Right? Why Hekin Ashi over candlestick charts, or why is this even created? It is created to give a kind of noise filtration, a kind of averaging over the candlestick. So what I mean by that is, let's say if I have to show you SBIN chart or any other chart per se, right? So this chart is candlestick, and it shows, for those who don't know, right? This shows a lot of price movement, price gap ups, which, like, as you can see here, price opened up and then fell down, right? Those kind of things are not sort of present if you see it in Hekin Ashi. So if I just say Hekin Ashi, it looks much more smoother, shows a much clearer trend, but there are obviously things to watch out for when using Hekin Ashi, so we'll cover that, right? So Hekin Ashi can be used to identify trending periods, period reversal points, and classic, and can also be used with classic technical analysis patterns. So understanding Hekin Ashi formula, if anybody wants me to slow down, do let me know. This is very simple and straightforward, but has a very strong meaning to it. Open price of Hekin Ashi is previous candles open and close average. So what I mean by that is, let me just plot two charts here so I can quickly just explain for people who are not familiar with Hekin Ashi and how it works. Okay, so this candle, where my cursor, let me just zoom in for clarity. Okay, this candle where my cursor is, this one, Hekin Ashi, which is this open price here, which is 303.83, is the open price. This is the open price of the second Ashi candle. This is equal to the previous candle, which is one day before candles, close and opens average. So if you see, it is average of these two, right? So that is how Hekin Ashi's open is formed. Close is nothing but the current candles open, close, high, low, divide by four. So it's just an average of today's candle in middle. Hekin Ashi maximum or Hekin Ashi maximum is nothing but maximum of open, close, high, and minimum is nothing but minimum of open, close, or low. Okay, great. So now this is something which is quite important to understand when, if you need to build chart pattern strategy with Hekin Ashi, or if you want to build something that sort of captures the momentum or trend that is what Hekin Ashi is meant to capture or to show, right? So Hekin Ashi candles with no lower shadows indicate uptrend. What I mean by this, let me show that here. So this is a Hekin Ashi candle, correct? This is the top one chart is an Hekin Ashi candle. If it doesn't have a lower shadow, that means if it doesn't have a lower wick, so this is what a lower shadow looks like. Let me just show it here. This is a lower shadow. If you see this, where my mouse cursor is moving, this is a lower shadow. This doesn't have a shadow. This indicates that the trend is strong. I mean, that's what Hekin Ashi is supposed to show, right? And the momentum is going to continue. For the other thing, for the red candles, right? If the Hekin Ashi candle is red and doesn't have an upper shadow, if it doesn't have the top wicks, that means the bottom trend is going to is supposed to continue and there is momentum. There is no obviously guarantee of that because this is not this is just a chart pattern which averages the previous values and is sort of lagging in nature, but it sort of gives you a average out view of the trend. Last point on this, small candles with both upper and bottom and upper shadow show that a reversal might come. So you see here it was a flat wick candle, it doesn't have a upper shadow. Now a doji like candle came, right? It has both upper and bottom shadow and the trend reversed. Now again this candle came, but it didn't sort of sustain because next candle again was doji and then the trend continued, right? So this is something where Heknashi is most useful for, and this is what technically generally people when using price trends to identify continuing trends or price movement trends use Heknashi for, right? So some, okay, this is sort of not required. Okay, so strategy with Heknashi, let's get to this. This is what most of the people have requested for, right? So you can build a lot of strategies with Heknashi, everything from price breakout to momentum strategies, because Heknashi captures volume as well. I mean, it doesn't sort of remove volume like how Renko does. You can use technical strategies on Heknashi using volume as a factor as well there, right? Like if a volume is higher than moving average of previous volume, things like that can be used with Heknashi. In this webinar, we'll cover three strategies. One will be a chart pattern on Heknashi. Second one will be super trend and an ATR combination, and other one will be just super trend. So having said that, so that it gives you an overview of what is to come next. So you can phrase your questions now on and keep so that we can answer it once we get there. Right. So this is first strategy. This strategy basically is trying to capture this. This is a buy strategy. It is trying to capture this moment. So if you have two continuous flat bottom green candles, it'll take the trade post that and it'll ride till it sees two red candles with flat tops. What I mean by flat tops, it doesn't have a upper wick and it enters when it has it doesn't have a lower wick, right? This is what the strategy generally tries to cover. Let's create this and see how this works out. Great. So let me add just a few stocks here. I'm using 15 minute chart, so I can also change this here to 15 minutes. Let's see how we can create chart patterns on Streak for Heknashi and validate our theory, right? The logic or theory says that if the candle is flat bottom, the trend will continue upwards. And if a doji comes or a two flat bottom, sorry, flat top red candles come, that means trend is supposed to reverse, right? So that's the strategy we are trying to create here. So let's to say that the current candle is a green candle. All you have to say is open is lower than close. Now to say that the bottom is flat. So example is like this one, right? So this is a flat bottom candle. If you want to capture this, you just have to say open is equal to low. So this basically says that open is equal to low, right? Because this is the open price and this is also the low price. You can see on top here, right? Open is equal to low, which is 301.70. Now we want to see two candles like this form, two continuous candles, not just one, right? We don't just want one candle because first candle can reverse in the next Heknashi or it can disappear. So we want to see whether a trend has sort of formed in and is going to continue. So I will also check whether the previous candle was a green flat bottom candle or a candle without any shadow. So to say green, I will just say previous open is lower than previous close. And previous open is equal to low. Okay, so this forms our entry. Now we have to, so if you see here, we have also added ADX lower than 24. We can see why that is. So let me just add that indicator here as well. So with ADX lower than 25, not this one. What is being trying to show, what is being shown, what is trying to be captured here is the trend is starting as shown by Heknashi, but ADX, which is a 14 period lagging indicator, still hasn't picked up yet. So there is still room for the trend to continue. That's what is trying to be captured here. You can play with it, you can modify it to sort of match your chart patterns or your chart requirements, which you have sort of seen over years or days. Okay, now as I explained, the exit is nothing but reverse of this two flat top green candles. That's what it is trying to, two flat top red candles. That's what it is trying to capture. So to say a candle is red, you can just say open is higher than close, which basically means price opened and then fell so that it closed. And then to say it's a flat top, you have to say open is equal to high. So you see how the difference is. It's quite straightforward. If you want to capture a red candle in Heknashi with flat top, you just say open is equal to high because that's the price there. And then the bottom wick is going to be lower than the close, but you don't actually need to worry about that. You just need to focus on this one in this style. But if you want to also see whether the downtrend is continuing, you can use low should be lower than the previous low. So you make sure that lower lows are being formed and higher highs are being formed when especially going in bullish trend like this. So that also can be created very easily. Let me just finish the strategy. So I am saying previous candle is also a red candle and it is a flat top candle. Flat top basically means it doesn't have an upper shadow. So I'll say previous open is equal to previous high. Okay, so the reason why I'm making this stop loss and take profit 99% is because I want to enter and exit here. So again, this is just to explain how the chart patterns can be captured. To add Heknashi, you just have to click on this advanced button, which you see here at the bottom. And then you can just say, and this is a CNC and RML more towards positional strategy. And then you can, then you just have to give a name and then we can. Let me add some other stocks. Let's just backtest it. So I think I might have made a mistake in the strategy that's why it's saying no trades have happened. Let me just take a quick look. Okay, so this is the mistake. It should be previous open is equal to previous low, because we want to make sure that the previous candle was a flat bottom candle. Now, just correcting that mistake sort of should give backtest results that we can see. While the backtests are running, we can also look at the strategy and sort of understand that what it is trying to do. It is just trying to capture the chart patterns and give the results on that. So we see that it didn't take many trades for this period. There was just one trade. This is just the chart pattern of this. So we can see what can be changed to improve the strategy, right? First, let's see whether this strategy takes a trade when we wanted it to. So it took first trade on 15th Jan, and post that it has not taken any trades. And here also it has taken few trades. Let me just again look at the strategy, because this is a chart pattern. I need to be very careful in writing it. Okay, so this should have been equal to. That's where the mistake was again. So again, to be clear, to clarify this, it is open higher than close, so that it is a red candle. Then open is equal to high, so that it's a flat top candle. Now here we have it, right? This is what we were building for. So we can see how this strategy performs. It has a decently small max drawdown. Ashok Leyland performs better than Wellspend, right? We have ICICI Bank, which also does quite decent, right? So this is how you can capture a chart. You can build strategies with the chart patterns that you see in Heiken Ashi. You can also say that if higher highs are being formed in Heiken Ashi, you want to buy. And as soon as the trend flattens out, you want to exit. And you can backtest it and make sure optimize it. We have our first webinar covers on how to optimize the strategies and make sure that they work for the stocks that you are choosing for and they work for the period that you are trying it for, right? So let's move to the next strategy, which is a technical indicator based strategy. I think you guys will enjoy this a bit more. Let me just clear the layout out so we can just plot the strategy very quickly. Just a minute, guys. Great. So now this strategy, what it tries to say is if it tries to sell if supertrend gives a sell, and it also looks at the true range crossing below ATR along with SMA. So let me just plot those indicators. You need to understand why these strategies are being built the way they are and what they are trying to convey. It's just a starting point where you can build things that you visualize, which you see on charts, on streak, and try out which combination works for you the best for your risk to reward ratio and things like that. Let me plot these indicators so I can quickly explain. Meanwhile, if you guys have any questions, you can just type it in the chat box. Great. So I have plotted the strategy here. It basically says it will do a sell at this point of time when Supertrend in Heiken Ashi says a sell, and the close price is lower than the close price here is lower than the 200 moving average, in addition to the true range crossing above ATR. Now, why two range crossing above ATR? See, average two range will show you the average amount of movement that the stock is doing, right? Whereas two range is not the average. So it says if any kind of price spike, like if any kind of spike in price is happening, along with a sell supertrend indication, it has to sell. That's the strategy here, right? It's quite simple and straightforward. Stop loss is directly 1%. Take profit is 2.5%. This is an intraday strategy for those guys who initially requested, hey, can we have an intraday strategy? So I can add the stocks. So this is on a 5-minute chart. Obviously, I showed you the chart of 5 minutes here with Heiken Ashi. So it is 5 minutes. Let me just create the strategy. It'll take okay. Why the parameters 10.4? I mean, because it sort of accounts for a longer period, so a more stabler trend. Keep in mind, Heiken Ashi as it is. One second. Let me just finish the creating the strategy, so then I can continue explaining what I was saying. So I'm saying two range, basically the range in which the stock is moving has crossed above ATR. That means we see a kind of momentum, not momentum. We see a kind of price movement happening in a very sort of a flat market, right? So possibly a kind of trend would be developing, and we want to make sure that we are there to capture that price move. So again, this is very healthy win to loss ratio. It is 1% and 2.5%. Okay, it is on Heiken Ashi chart. So let me just change that. Right. This is an intraday strategy. For those who had asked, can we showcase an intraday strategy with Heiken Ashi? So let the backtest run. So meanwhile, the backtests are running. Let me just explain what this is trying to do. So in this scenario, it will buy exactly here when Supertrend gave us sell. But many times, a Supertrend can give us sell in a very flat market, and the markets might not move. Right? Because Supertrend is more towards showing the trend, but not the strength of the trend. But if Supertrend gives a sell, and see here, the signal would not have come. Let me just show where. Here, the signal would not have come because the true range is lower than the ATR. It has not given a spike that there a price move is happening, a downwards price move is happening, even though Supertrend has given a sell and EMA is lower than 50. It would have given that here when the actual trend is sort of starting, and then the algo would have entered here and then got squared off at a point at a price in lower in profit, right? So I think I forgot to change buy to sell because this is a sell strategy. My bad. Let's run the backtest again. Great. So as we can see, this performs much better, right? With SBIN, it has done like amazing results. So it has, even though the stock has gone 2% up, shorting with this strategy has resulted in 14% profit, right? I mean, that's obviously in the backtest. So even though we didn't know that in this period, the stock can go up or go down, this strategy can be used to short in addition to sort of, I mean, obviously you have to backtest it and make sure it works good for your stocks which you are trying. Now, win to loss ratio is amazing. It's 17 wins and one loss, 14 wins. 14 is the winning streak. That means it continues to win 14 times in a row and loses only once with a max drawdown of 1.4%. So these are the kind of strategies that can be created, right? With Heiken Ashi. Now you can try this with Candlestick and see how this, what is the difference between the returns that you get from both. But as As Hekinashi, I have explained earlier, is a bit of a lagging indicator, is a bit of a lagging price because it accounts for the previous prices as well. The indicators become more smoother and are sort of more stabler, and they will not just say buy now and just sell in the next candle. That's what I'm trying to say. It's become less choppy, right? So that's the second strategy, using super trend and ATR with TR with EMA. So I'll pause for a minute and I'll take any questions that you guys have posted till now before we move on to the third strategy. Please check for BEL. We'll do that in the next strategy. Are you checking for spike in volatility? iStock has asked. Absolutely, we are. We are looking at how does, like, is there a spike in volatility along with Hekinashi showing downtrend with supertrend and EMA? So Suresh has asked, EMA will be 50. Okay, sir. So Suresh, EMA 50 can work, but the issue with EMA 50 is it doesn't capture a bit of a longer trend. And here with Hekinashi, we are trying to capture trend itself. Please add stochastic RSI. Please add trailing stop loss. So Chetan, stochastic RSI is already there if you want to build strategies with that. I can try to build a strategy live now and show, but it will take a couple of tries to optimize it. Trailing stop loss is already added as part of bracket. So obviously, you cannot backtest it currently, but if you deploy anything as BO, you can use that, and once the notification comes, you can give a trailing stop loss, and it'll capture the trailing stop loss, and it'll go with that. Can you use Venu has asked, can you use EMA 5, 8, 13 with HA? Obviously, you can use. You have to build strategies like that. Let me just scroll through questions. Okay, I've added SBI and iStock. You had asked that. Can you? So Sentil has asked, hey, can you please tell me Supertrend 10.4? So we did Supertrend 10.4, right? So Shailesh has asked, Renko is one gray area which Zerodha has not touched. We did a webinar. Our third webinar was on explaining Renko, and it was a 1 hour long webinar covering everything that you want to sort of explore and things to keep watch out for when using Renko. Riyas has asked, commodities we can use with this strategy? Yes, you can. You have to backtest and make sure that it works. Obviously, if you want, I can backtest currently for crude or something. Hi, Vijendra has asked, hi, what ADX level do you use for sell in Hekinashi? I mean, you have to see for the stock itself. ADX itself doesn't show how much of a buy bullish or a bearish trend is there, but plus DI and minus DI do. So if you use minus DI and say that minus DI has crossed over 30, it is possibly a good sell. You have to backtest it and see. I see you added ADX lower than 24 to buy. Yes, we did, because Vijendra, again, you had asked, why did we do that? We did that because if ADX is lower than 24, ADX higher than 24 basically means that bullish and bearish trends, plus DI and minus DI, are both sort of averaging out to 24. That means trend is neutral. Now, when Hekinashi is starting to give green candles, which are going up, flat bottom green candles, and ADX still has not shown the trend to start, there is a possibility that the trend is starting. That's why we try to backtest with that. For intraday, what are the tools you to use? You can use Kite and Streak. Kite, you can do place orders, see the charts, and with Streak, you can backtest and track all the up to 100 stocks and get the right opportunities to enter at right point of time, so that you never miss a trade, and you can execute that with Streak where the order goes through Kite, and you can see everything there as well. Can you show how stochastic RSI can be plotted? Can't find it in the list. Purva, you have to go to profile, change the chart from Chart IQ to Trading View, come back open the chart and then just type stochastic RSI. I think that's it. We'll just go to the next strategy for those people who have been waiting patiently. Right, so this strategy is again just a simple one. It doesn't do too many trades in past 3 months. Quite smoothly it works, right? You can try many more iterations on that. It had a good win to loss ratio. Now next strategy is going to be a super trend strategy again, but you see here it says super trend 7, 3, -1. Now -1 is what is called offset, which you basically when see charts you don't have to plot that. Let me just plot that here. I will just say 7, 3. Now this is the, and I'll just remove other indicators for the sake of clarity. Great. What this strategy is doing, is it is saying that previous super trend, okay, this is a sell strategy. Previous super trend should be higher than close. And current super trend should be lower than super trend 3, -1, right? So what it is trying to say is this. It is trying to capture this slope. That's all it is trying to capture. If I have to give in a very simple summary, it is trying to say that the price is, the super trend is still having this kind of slope. So if I have to draw a line so that people understand what the strategy is trying to capture, let me just draw a line. It is trying to capture this slope. If supertrend gives a slope like this, it will take a trade, and not when supertrend, even after giving a sell here, is staying flat. Okay. Let me repeat this again. It will take a trade only when this red line, which line with two dots, which you can see here, is highlighted. When supertrend starts to dip, that's when it takes a trade on Heike-Nashi chart, not on regular chart, right? And it doesn't take a trade when super trend, even after giving a sell, stays flat. This is very important to understand because it helps capture the trend which super trend was trying to indicate, but at the right moment, and also avoids this kind of price up moves even after super trend has given a sell, or it can also be used when it gives buy. So here it gave multiple times, but because the price is still falling, you can add this chart pattern also that candle should not have a wick and they should be green. So let's create this strategy. Let's add same stocks we have been trying till now. The reason why I'm using the same stock is to show consistency of one multiple strategies on same kind of stocks, so that you know this can be adopted broadly for various kind of markets, various kind of stocks. You have to find the chart pattern in the right way, and then you can use it for various stocks broadly, is what I'm trying to say. Right. So first choose the stocks, then try to do analysis on that and build strategies. Okay, the strategy, it's a sell. So strategy is very simple. I'll just say super trend 7, -1 is higher than close. So it basically shows that it's a sell. You can say higher than close, higher than previous close. I'm just using higher than close, right? Then we also are saying the current candle super trend. So if I keep offset zero, for those people who don't understand, offset zero means current candle, okay, is lower than previous, sorry, super trend, and then I can just say -1. Okay, let me just quickly explain it here. All we are trying to say is the current candle super trend, let's say this is the current candle, where my cursor is, this is lower than the previous candle, so that we know super trend is sort of falling down and following the price. Now, again, take profit is very simple. Exit for this is kept very simple. 1% stop loss, 2% take profit. Let's try that. Obviously, candle here is 1 hour. The reason why this strategy, even though it is intraday, it is taking 1 hour, is to avoid the kind of flats which you are seeing with 5 minutes. So it will sort of take a trade here and then it will ride for a couple of hours. Then probably next day it will take a trade here and ride for a couple of hours for selling. Our candle with Hekinashi sort of smoothens out a couple of things, especially when you are trying to capture slope and all. Let's give it name. Let's don't forget to change this to Hekinashi, because that's very important. It's Hekinashi, Hekinashi. You can pronounce it anyway, right? So let's see this result. So it gives, it takes a lot of trades, but it gives decent amount of results for something like the stocks that we are seeing, right? So Tata Motors fell 43%. It gives 22% returns. Decent, but not that impressive. SBIN rose up 19% in last 1 year, but shorting it, the strategy made 16%. Obviously, you can do both ways. You can have a buy strategy and a sell strategy. Buy strategy, irrespective of market going up or down, if it is able to capture the right opportunities and make positive returns. And a sell strategy, irrespective of market going up or down, if it can capture the right kind of moves and get the positive returns, then you basically have strategies that make money in either direction of the markets, right? So that's the whole point with backtesting. You can sort of build this kind of strategies. You can see what works, what doesn't work. You can make sure that your chart patterns are correct. You can make sure you are capturing your ideas correctly, right? And know what are the right points to enter and exit. Let me just remove this. Great. So pitfalls to watch out for, a couple of things very important which people using Hekinashi should know. Hekinashi, when you look at it, gives a false sense of price, right? You see that, hey, you can buy here and then you can sell here, and there's a gap of what, some 298 to 311. But the underlying candlesticks, that price is quite different. If you see my, okay, I can show you that as well. I mean, I think, let me just show it here. Just give me a second. I'll just make it. I'm just showing PNB because that was just what opened first. But if you see here, right, we can see that Hekinashi gives us a price of something like 74.31 or 38, but at that point, if we enter here and you go here and you see 83, but the price difference is there because it is an average of previous candles and not the actual price. So you should always make sure that whenever you are looking at the Hekinashi, you are also looking at the underlying actual OHLC candles to see what price you are getting. Okay. And our backtest actually covers that. So all the backtest signals that you see here, all the trades which are happening here, right? Every entry, every exit which you see here, this, even though the signal is generated for an Hekinashi candle, let's say the signal is generated for this candle, hypothetically, it will take the open price of next OHLC candle. So our backtest platform makes sure that, and I don't recall any other platform sort of accounting for this, especially those self-coded ones where you don't know, you don't actually think about this so deeply that you account for the underlying prices and underlying moves, right? So that is account for. So other thing is, popular candlesticks become invisible and hard to recognize when using Hekinashi. So when you see like three void soldiers or hammer and all, those sort of disappear because Hekinashi only have actually three patterns, only doji, then you have a flat bottom and a flat top candle. And you can say if three are going green, you can still count it as three white soldiers, but it actually is not, I mean, you cannot actually see major kind of sort of engulfing kind of patterns and all those things, all those kind of patterns you can't see in Hekinashi. So Hekinashi sort of has that slight disadvantage. Other thing is indicator, which I explained earlier also, indicators become more laggy on Hekinashi charts because Hekinashi is nothing but accounting for current price and previous price, and indicators already are laggy because they use 14 candle period or 15 candle period. So everything becomes super smoothened out. So you should keep that in mind. So the reason I'm saying this point is important is because you have to then choose the right candle. So you cannot, like, if you are using candlestick for 1 hour with technical, if you want to move that to Heikin-Ashi, you should probably explore 30 minute or a 15 minute lower candle, because it sort of balances out the lagginess which is coming in versus the trend which you're trying to capture, right? Now, that's about it, guys. If you have any questions, I can answer those as well. Any requests, I can try to build that. So, Preetpal Singh is asking, what does backtesting means? Backtesting basically means this. I mean, for those people who are not aware of that, backtesting basically means testing your strategy, testing your idea, and checking whether if you would have bought and sold on that condition in last 3 months or last any period you choose, how would the result would have been, what results or returns you would have gotten. Backtesting, as the name says, back and testing. It's testing your idea, your strategy, whatever you want to call it, on historical data, on past data, and seeing whether it has made some sense or not, right? It had made money or not. And based on that, you can do the deployment and then you can try it out with looking at the notification and checking whether it is actually making sense for you or not, and then taking from there. For those who were asking how to use BO, again, this is an MIS strategy. To do use BO, all you have to select is product, regular, and make it BO, and just click confirm. Once it is deployed as BO, if a condition meets, you will get a BO buy sell window here. And in that, you can give your trailing stop loss if you want it. And it's just one click. If you just click once, your stop loss, take profit are automatically placed, and once the entry order is completed, stop loss and take profit are tracked for you, right? Let me just look at other questions. Please backtest crude oil and silver strategy. Dilpesh, I can try it for this, but again, this levels of 1% and 2% stop loss and take profit might not be the right levels for crude or anything that you are looking at, because they move differently. So it's better if you backtest it with yourself, right? Great. So thank you, guys. Thank you for being with me. And as always, have a nice day. Bye-bye. Take care.